So the directory is a distributed structure across the course. It's not centralized in one place, like the bus. So not all requests have to go to the same part of the directory. Each slice of the directory will serve a set of blocks, where a slice of the directory is the part of the directory that is next to a particular core. And that means that different blocks will be served by slices that are in different places. And that's how we achieve a higher bandwidth, because really each slice could operate independently because it serves a disjoint set of blocks. What does a slice do? It has one entry for each block served by that slice, and the entry for a block tracks which caches in the system have this block in a non-invalid state, of course, because the block in an invalid state is like it's not in that cache at all. And the order of accesses for a particular block is determined by the home slice for that block. That's the slice of the directory that has the entry for this block. We call that the home slice of the directory. So pretty much, accesses that go to the same block are almost serialized in how they can access their entry, and the order in which that happens is the order in which the accesses are officially said to happen. Note that with the directory protocol, the caches still have the same states they did with snooping. It's just now, when we send a request to read or write, that request no longer goes on a bus. It gets sent via our network to the directory. So we can have many requests traveling to their individual slices, and then the directory figures out what to do.